everyone. I'm Shelley Rosenblum, curator of academic programs here at the Belkin. Thank you so much for coming out on this glorious day. We're really happy to have you here. As you may know, the exhibition closes this weekend, so please take some time to visit the show. We are thrilled, as always, to have contemporary players here. To Corey and Paolo, thank you very much. We really we love the rhythm of having you here every semester, and I can't imagine not having a semester with a concert with all of you here and your students. So thank you for thinking through this exhibition and preparing the program today. Thanks for coming.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks everybody for coming to the concert. I'm Corey Tam, this is Paolo Bortolussi, and we're really excited to be here today for the concert, as we always are. We're so appreciative to Shelley and the Belkin Gallery for having us every semester. It's also our pleasure to come here and play. And today it's particularly cool. What a fantastic space to play in, a fantastic stage, and extra people to listen. And, so it's going to be great. And today, because of the difference in stage, we have solos. We have three soloists for you today, and then one trio as well. Fascinating music, so I'm sure you're going to enjoy it. So let's start, and I should apologize to Tommy. Our first performer, his name, of course, is Tommy Bo. It says Boo, and I apologize for the mistake in the program, but it's Tommy Bo. And he'll tell you a little bit about his two pieces.
My name is Tommy and I play the euphonium. Today I'm going to be playing two pieces. The first one is going to be Cascades by Alan Vizzutti. Alan Vizzutti is a world-renowned trumpet player, and he wrote this piece based on a motive that he played throughout his entire high school career, basically. And he wrote it down on paper one day, and then he composed the rest of the piece. The second piece that I'll be playing is Tonoi number 9. It's part of a bunch of instrument solos, a part of a series, and this is the 9th one in the series. And Nickitas Demos wrote these for friends that he's met along his career. So this one is dedicated to euphonium player Adam Fry. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. And it'll be followed directly by Takemitsu's Paths. So Emotion was first exposed to me this summer at a new music festival that I attended. I'm only going to play a few movements from it because it is quite a lengthy work. His idea is that it's for, he says, for trumpet reciting, so like commentary, and choreography. So I'm not going to dance for you today. But I will be reciting the poem and then playing the movement that follows the poem. It is in French, so if you speak French, great. I hope I don't offend you with my accent. And if you don't, I'll read the first four lines of the poem in English for you right now. So it is. It was from her soft liftoff that my eyes followed her, suspending my glance on her turning hesitations. She traced a thread in the space of the room. Like an eye, sorry. Then rolling up, she dressed herself in a bubble. I hope you enjoy these selections. C'était son un vol du que mes yeux la suivant.
Thank you.
have Enoch Ng playing a piece by György, Ligeti. And if you know Ligeti's music, you may be expecting something like his very dense, active piano etudes or some of his early pieces like Atmosphere for Orchestra, which is also dense but not rhythmic, it's just these giant clusters. This piece, however, the first movement from his Viola Sonata, is very melodic and folk-inspired, basically. It's a tune, a beautiful tune, and he plays around with tuning within that melody as well. And it's, like I say, it's the first movement of his Viola Sonata, which also includes some very active and even crazy movements, but this one is sort of more calm.
Thank you. Henryk Górecki, the famous Polish composer,
and this piece is an early work by Górecki, very unlike his beautiful Symphony of Sorrowful Songs, which you may have heard, this fantastic melodic piece. So this is quite violent, this trio, and almost electronic in its silence that come out of the string players. It's kind of amazing piece.